We got this poster for This Island Earth. It's in pretty good condition, except it's paperbacked. You see, it's on an old paperbacking. Paperbacking doesn't do anything to give it a good support, so it still has the folds showing, the center crease especially. So we're gonna take the old lining, the old paperbacking off this poster and linen back it today on Posterfix. Taking this backing paper off has proved to be a little bit harder than we thought, but it's all in a day's work for Posterfix. We've taken this poster, this original one sheet for This Island Earth, off an old backing, and now we're going to linen back it. As you can see, there's rips in here and damaged missing paper, and this will all come together when it's linen backed. Because of the fragility of the poster, I'm going to apply the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper.
This Island Earth is a 1955 American science fiction film from Universal International, produced by William Alland, directed by Joseph M. Newman and Jack Arnold, starring Jeff Moreau, Faith Domager, and Rex Reason. It is based on the eponymous 1952 novel by Raymond F. Jones, which was originally published in the magazine Thrilling Wonder Stories as three related novelettes. The film was released in 1955 as a double feature with Abbott and Costello Meet the Mummy. Upon initial release, the film was praised by critics who cited the special effects, well-written script, and the eye-popping technicolor as being its major assets.
I'm spraying water to it to help it expand. And it is expanding, so I've got to try to help it expand by stretching it out. I'm trying not to tear it while I do it, but it's already tearing because it's torn previously. This is where my 37 years of restoring posters comes in helpful, because I'm pretty good at manipulating wet paper. Oh, that's good. Kind of. Now I'm using a roller to push out the excess wheat paste and the air pockets. This poster paper is thin and it absorbs the wheat paste very quickly, which makes it expand quickly and stretch out. So I think it's going to come out quite good. I had two posters of this title in the shop, and I got the customers mixed up and kept sending the wrong information to the owner of this poster, thinking that the other poster was his poster. Sorry about that. That's what happens if I get two identical posters in the shop at a time. Sometimes people think that their collecting habits are so unique and special that I couldn't possibly have two of the same posters at a time. That's what I think is so funny. Everybody collects the same shit. I mean, no, really, I get my fair share of Star Wars posters. I don't do videos much about the Star Wars posters I get, because I get too many of them and I get tired of it. And for some reason, all the Star Wars people want me to do videos about their poster. And I say, well, you know what? Your poster is not so special. I already did a video about that poster just 2 weeks ago. This, though, it's unusual. I've never gotten to This Island Earth in the shop in 37 years, and now suddenly I get two at the same time. I think that's kind of funny. I gotta go in there with a spatula and turn some paper around. So So first I'm going to roll out the edges. So that the paper is staying put. Now I'm taking some sponges and wiping off the wheat paste so that the face of the poster is clean. You know, I'm a science fiction fan, especially of 50s science fiction, yet I've never seen this movie in its entirety. I've only seen clips. The paper is so fragile, I'm reluctant to really wipe it hard. All right, let me get my spatula. Somehow some paper got curled in under here while I was rolling it out. There. That's better. Here's another area. Hey, caramba.
This Island Earth was released in June of 1955, and by the end of that year had accrued $1,700,000 in distributors domestic, United States and Canada, that is, rentals, making it the year's 74th biggest earner. A review in the New York Times by Howard Thompson stated, quote, "The technical effects of This Island Earth, Universal's first science fiction excursion in color, are so superlatively bizarre and beautiful that some shortcomings can be excused, if not overlooked," unquote. Scream Factory has released the film on Blu-ray with a new 4K scan of the interpositive in two different aspect ratios, 185:1 and 137:1. The 137:1 version is available for rental views on YouTube. I'm giving it a final wipe down with the sponge to make sure it's nice and clean. Then it'll dry for a couple of days, then I'll cut it down and trim it nice and square. And here we are, the finished poster, This Island Earth, a 1955 one sheet, relined at Posterfix, where we bring your vintage posters back to life.